Hello everyone, myself Maruti, welcoming you all to the map videos here. Right, in this video, I'm going to explain a topic regarding progressions, arithmetic progressions, and in that one, what are the different ways of finding any required term? We like to call it as specific term. It might be fourth term, it might be sixth term, 10th term, whatever it might be, right? And what are the methods a question can be given to you? So the entire concept I'm going to cover in this video in a logical way. Let's go for this one. Progressions, that is what? Finding the specific term, any term. Okay, now. So my concept is to find any term in AP, we use nth term formula. That's what we say. We use the nth term formula. What's the nth term formula? Nth term formula, an is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. Okay, so that is the nth term formula. To find any term n of AP, we use that. Now, what are the variables in that formula? What are the variables in that formula? The first one is nothing but a. A is nothing but first term. A, the first term. T is nothing but the common difference. The difference between any two terms of AP is nothing but common difference. N means, as I said to you earlier in my last videos, N means roll number or position number. And AN means the term, the number sitting in that roll number. You got it. So, I like to take this one right now. How can the question be asked? Now, for an example, what I am doing means, I am taking example, find the 16th term. So, what is the specific term? 16, right? Now, if you think about the question, what is the question asked for you? He is asking 16th term. So, how you are going to write it down? We are going to write it as A16, which is the question mark here. Okay, find the 16th term means the number which is sitting in the 16th position. So, as he has given find the 16th term, directly we can say that n is equal to 16. By seeing the subscript at the bottom, which term, which roll number? 16 he is asking. Straight away we can say n is equal to 16. Is it clear? Now, what are the other two things? First term and common difference. So, these two are missing here, A and D, right? So, if you know the values of A and D, we can straight away find the 16th term by using the formula A plus N minus 1 into D. Now, what is N? 16. We can place 16 in the place of N. Okay, A16, this is what? A16 is equal to how much? So, we need A and D now. If you know the values of A and D, A, D and N, if you substitute in this one, we can find A16. So, now, how can the A and D given for you in the examination or in the question? According to me, I have classified, to make you easy, I have classified into four methods. How can be A and D? A means first term, D means common difference. Now, first method is nothing but I like to call it as direct method. So, directly he will be giving A and D for you. I will show you. The second method I like to call it as series method. The third method I like to call it as one term method. And the fourth method I like to call it as two term method. I repeat, first method, direct method. Second method, series method. Third method, one term method. I will let you know. So, fourth method is two term method. These are the general ways I want my students to remember it as. Now, let's come back to the direct method. So, what is this first method, direct method called as? It's nothing but direct method. So, what he is giving? A and D, directly he will give it to you. So, assume that first term he will give directly to you in the given question. First term A is equal to something like 2, he will give it to you. And in the same way D, he will directly give it to you. Common difference, right, common D is equal to 4, directly will give it to you. Now what is asking? Find the 16th term. Now let's find nth term formula, A plus N minus 1 into D. right? What we want, A16, let us plug in A16 here. What is the A value here? 2. And what is the N value? As by seeing the bottom as 16, plug in 16 here. 16 minus B, how much you got? 4. Let us substitute 2 plus 16 minus 5, 15 into D. Here it is nothing but 2 plus 60, which is nothing but 62. So 16th term, how much you got? 62. So this is how the first method. In few questions you'll be. Now let's go for the second method now. Right here, as we have seen, the first term, the first method, direct method, we got the 16th term. Yes, we got the 16th term. Okay, now how the question will be given in the second model? Right, again the same, find the 16th term, right? Direct method, it is done. Direct method, as we all know, directly A will be given and directly D will be given. Now, in the second method, series method, means instead of giving A is equal to so and so, directly D is equal to so and so, he will give you a series. Okay, to make you better understand, I am framing a series basing upon the same first term and the common difference. Okay, let us work it out. Let me take the series. The first term, let me take the first term as 2. Okay, now what is the common difference? 4. I like to add 4 to this one. As we know, if you add the 4, right, if you add the 4, you'll get the second term. I like to take the second term as 6. Okay, again you know arithmetic progression means common difference. Let me add again 4 to this one, the common difference. Again, I got the term as 10. Okay, in the same way, if you add, we'll be getting 14 and so on, right? Of course, just to make you better understand, I have framed a series in the same way. So in the question, he'll be giving like this. Forget about that one now. Wantedly I framed. Now he'll be giving. The series is given series. Given series, right, of AP. He will be giving this in the question. Given series is so and so. Find the 16th term. Okay. From this series, how to find A and B? The concept is finding the 16th term, right? In the, how do you get A and B? He has given in terms of a series. What is the series? Given series 2, 6, 10, 14, and so on. From this series, how to get the values of A and B? Of course, I framed convenient for us, but from to get it here, as if like here, right? A is equal to, A1 is equal to 2, the first one. Right, A2 is equal to the second term. We have to find the common difference. Common difference, you have to remember the formula. The difference between any two terms, difference between these two terms or these two terms or these two terms, any two. But I like to take the first one. Difference between A2 minus A1 is equal to 6 minus 2, which is nothing but 4. So what is the common difference we got? 2. So A, he, by seeing the first term, we got the value of A, and by finding the difference between any two consecutive terms, we got the difference as 4. Now in the same way, we have to find the formula. So what's that one? Let's go like this. It's nothing but An is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D, as we have done earlier. What is asking? 16th term, which is nothing but A plus 16 minus 1, 15D, which is equal to, what's the A value got? 2. And 15 into, what is the common difference? 4, of course, which is nothing but 62. So here he has given directly A and D. Here he has given series. From that, we have found the 16th term. We have found the A and D. From there onwards, by using the nth term formula, we have used what? We have found the 16th term. Now let's get back to the another model. Model 3 or method 3. One term method. Means here, both he has given directly to you. Here, A and D he has given in terms of series. Now, one term method means what? He will be giving A or D to you, A or D, as if like this, here both he has given, but in this one, the one term method, any one among A and D will be given to you. Example, right, I like to take first term, A is equal to 2, this is given in the question. Okay, he has given in the question directly, but he didn't give you D. Right. To find the value of D, he will ask you to go and take it from any other term. Bring it the D from the any other term. Example, I like to do 1, 2, 3, 4. Wantedly, I'm picking like this. Something like he will say, fourth term. Fourth term is 14. So he didn't give D to you. He didn't give you 2. He has given only A value. Right? To get to that D, he's asking them to go and take it from there. I'm not giving you directly. Go and take D from that term. So I'm going there to that term. What is the term he has given? Fourth term is 14. So A4, this is also given to you. This is also given to you. From this given part in the question paper, we have to get what we need, D. So A4 is equal to 14. How to write A4? A plus 3D is equal to 14. One less than this. Here if it is 4, you take 3. Now what is the A value? 2. 2 plus 3D is equal to 14. 3D is equal to 14 plus 2, if it comes to here, minus 2. 3D is equal to, it's nothing but 12. D is equal to 12 by 3, it's nothing but 4. Therefore, D is equal to 4. You got it. So, there, ENDD directly has given. Here, he has given series. Here, he has given one term. A is given directly, and to get the value of D, he asks you to go and take it from one more term. What is the term he has given? Fourth term is 14. Go and get D from there. So we went there. We went to the fourth term. From there onwards, I got the value of D. Now, A is ready. D is ready. As usual, plug in the formula. Find the specific term. What is the specific term? It's nothing but that. What's that? 16th term. 16th term is 2. Straight away, A and D, plug it in this one, we'll get it. Okay. Direct method. Series method. Next, one term method. Now, two terms method. Means here, if you check it out in one term method, one he has given, for the sake of D, he is asking us to go and take it from somewhere. Right, but in the two-term method, simple logic, what you guess is right. What's that? He won't give A to you. He won't give D to you. Both of them, he will ask us to go and get it from that term and this term. Totally two terms he will give. He'll be asking us to go there and get the values of from there onwards. For that one, I like to give like this. What is given? Something like, I will be taking from some. First term, second term, third term, fourth term. I will pick it from there only. I will take something like second term is, what's the second term? 6. Okay, right, he's asking us to go and get it from there. And you can say this one, fourth term, or otherwise I will take the fifth term for you. If you add 4 to that one, you get 80. So fifth term is 18. They both are given to you. This is given, he is asking us to go and get A and D from those two terms. Okay, let's take the first one. What he has given? Second term is 6. A2 is equal to 6. This is given for you. Okay, let us convert in terms of A's and D. See here, how to write A2? A plus, what is the number you have? 2. What is 1 less than that one? 1. 1D. A plus 1D is equal to how much? 6. I like to call it as equation 1. Yes. Okay, I got an equation. Right. Now, what is the other thing he has given? Fifth term is 18. A5 is equal to 18. This is also given to you. Okay. Converting A5 in terms of A's and D's. That is A plus, what is the number we have? 5. What is 1 less than that one? 4. So 4D is equal to 18. I like to call it as equation 2. Okay, this is definitely an essay sum for you, essay answer for you. So we are having two equations now. Solving equation 1 and 2. Solving equations 1 and 2. Okay, now out of these two equations, which is the bigger one? Which is the bigger one? If you check it out, here A and A are the same. Whereas, go for here, this is 1D and here it is 4D. Therefore, this becomes the bigger one. Always keep the bigger one on the top and the smaller one at the bottom. See here, second equation I like to take. What's the second equation?
a plus 4b is equal to 18. Now take the first equation underneath that, a plus 1b is equal to 2. Now let's solve both of them by subtraction. As you all know, if you have plus here, change it as minus. If you have plus here, change it as minus. And if you have plus here, change it as minus. Now cancel plus a and minus a. 4d minus 1d, it is equal to 3d. 18, it's nothing but 12. And 3d is equal to 12 by 3, it's nothing but 4. If you check it out properly, we got the same d as 4. But we need a also. Okay, for that one, what we are doing, substituting, what's that? D is equal to 4 in equation 1. Any one of these two equations, let us substitute to get the value of a. Now let us substitute in the first equation. Why? Because this is the easiest one. Substitute in that. So a plus 1d or b is equal to 6. Let us substitute there. A plus 4 is equal to 6. A is equal to 6 minus 4. A is equal to 2. Okay, what do you got? D. What do you got? A. Is it the same thing everywhere? So what to do after getting the values of A and D? Straight away use in the formula of nth term formula and get the value. If you want, I can do it for you. I can do it for you. An is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. We need a 16, a plus 15b, as we done here, which is nothing but 2 plus 15 into, it's 4, which is nothing but 62. Guys, be cool. Right, to find any term of AP, we are having 4 methods. If we are good at all these 4 methods, I bang you, man. We can do any sum from progression to find any term. But now there is a trick. We can ask you in different model. What is that? After getting A and D, he may ask you to find the series. Right, arithmetic series. Then what to do? Very simple. How many terms we need to form a series? 3. A1, A2, A3. What is A1? A. What is A2? A plus D. What is A3? A plus 2D. After getting A's and D's. In this channel, I have been placing both math and science videos.